Tell me where you were born and when you were born.
I was born on a farm between 6 Mile and Pickens in 1924.
Tell me about your life as a boy, young boy growing up.
Well, I had 3 sisters and 2 brothers, all older, and I think they kind of petted me, and I had a good early life.
Tell me about your time at age 11 at the Greenville News.
Well, I got up at 10 minutes to 4, carried a paper out, walked, had no bicycle. It's on mornings, it was pretty cold, but I did that for a long time. Until I got a job with Mr. Julian White, and I gave up the paper route because of him. Working for him was much better.
How much money did you make?
just a few dollars a week. Very few dollars a week.
Okay. Tell me about McCall Brothers Wholesale.
They were exceptionally good to me. I worked for them about 15 years, and I was general manager of McCall Wholesale and Starcross, which was a manufacturing of household textiles.
What was it like growing up back in the younger days with your mom and dad?
Well, families had the tendency to stay together. We didn't travel much because it was too expensive and too difficult. So mostly the farms nearby and us were the only neighbors and friends we had except to go into a country church on Sunday morning.
Yeah. How about your school years? What were they like?
My school years were excellent. I went to Northside, then to Easley High School, finished in 1942. met my wife and high school, and we were married after she graduated from college.
You have a lot of high school buddies, y'all?
Oh, yeah. We still, as a group of us, meet the first Tuesday morning of every month for breakfast. The crowds are getting a little slimmer now, but we're still doing it.
Yeah. So you met your wife at school. She was your...
Same grade. That's good.
Tell me about your career, how you got started in real estate.
Well, I decided that I had a good job. I wasn't upset with anybody, but I decided that if I was ever going to do anything on my own, I had to do it because I was running out of time. So I bought into a real estate firm and then later bought the other half, and it turned out to be the right move for me. One thing that I want to be sure to cover in this, that my wife taught school, which enabled me to build a real estate business. Without her help, it could not have been done.
She taught a lot of people, too. I know my son was one of them.
She taught 30 years and been extremely supportive.
So you began your real estate sales in 1964, is that right?
Right, that's right.
Okay.
And my secretary came to work not too long after that. And she's still with me, and her name is Nancy Day Albertson, and I couldn't have chosen a better one.
And she's been with you how long?
Over 40 years.
How about the KFC stores?
The first one was built in 1972, and then we have added 4 more. So we, Ozzy and I, have 5 KFC stores in operation now. And Clemson, Seneca, Easley, Powdersville, and Pickens.
How about Furman? Tell me a little bit about Furman.
Well, I went to Furman for a year and a half, and then went into the Army. And when I came out of the Army, I went to work. So I never did go back to finish school, but I did end up as a trustee at Furman for a term, and have been supportive of Furman ever since.
How about the State Development Board?
State Development Board was a 5-year appointment, and what we were doing was trying to attract industry, and we worked a lot at that. It was an unpaying job. The difficulty was we didn't have enough sewered properties to offer, but we were able to get Champion Spark Plug and Alstrom and some smaller plants to come into to the Easley Pickens area.
How about Palmetto Easley Baptist or Palmetto Baptist?
I served for 31 years on the board of Palmetto Baptist Health, a hospital in Columbia and Easley, and it was a great experience for me.
What other bank boards have you served on?
I served on the bank board of Carolina National Bank, C&S Bank, and one of the founders and bank board members of People's National Bank.
And you've been involved in developing some other things around.
Mr. Garrett and I developed Smithfield Country Club with clubhouse, swimming pool, tennis courts, about a golf course, 300 lots.
Tell me about going to China with these people.
Well, Ozzie Garrett and his wife Donna and Paul and I went to China just a few days after China was open for visitors. And it was a fabulous experience. We went to Tiananmen Square, and which would handle probably 2 million people at one time. They were not used to seeing a 6'5", white-headed man with big feet. And the children were just gravitated to us. It was quite an experience.
Where other places have you traveled during your time?
Japan, Hawaii, Europe, about 5 times, I guess. That's basically it.
Tell me about a little bit about your church.
Well, I've been a member of First Baptist Church, I believe it or not, for 70 years. I've been a deacon and Sunday school teacher for a long time. Very proud of my church. Still go, still very supportive of it. Got a great preacher, good Sunday school teachers. You can't beat that.
Tell me a little bit about your plaques that you have on the walls. I know you have quite a few, and you can...
Let's see. Well, I'll start with high school. I've got an award for a state championship in the discus throw and another state championship in the shot put. Belong to the Easley Athletic Hall of Fame for his place. Well, I have a plaque for carrying the Olympic torch in the 2002 Olympics, which was in Salt Lake City, but I carried the torch in Greenville. The governor appointed me with the Order of the Palmetto, which is a great, great honor, and I take it as such. I have a couple of things that the Easley folks have given me for Community Service Award. I've just been blessed any way you look at it. I had a phone call one day from San Diego, a friend of mine who was a minister and Nancy's brother-in-law was talking with Alvin Dark, who was coming through here on a speaking engagement. So Alvin got on the phone, and I knew he liked to play golf, so I asked him to just stop over and we would play golf. We did that, and after that, every time he came through the area, stopped and stayed at my house, and we played golf at various courses, and he kept talking about how much he liked it. So I just told him one day, I said, well, if you like it so well, why don't you just move here? So one day he called me from San Diego and said, have you picked a lot out at Smithfield? And I said, yes, we know where we're going to build a house. He said, well, I want the lot next door. So here he came, and he'd been a great asset to the city. and a great friend.
Do you have a most enjoyable time in your life that you can remember?
It's all been great. Really has. I don't think I mentioned the insurance business that Jim Black basically built, one of the finest men I've ever known, and the most knowledgeable insurance person I've ever known.
If you could change anything in your life, what would you change, or would you?
No, I would not. Very little. Well, I'd like. I'd be foolish if I didn't like. I wouldn't have liked to have had two eyes. But that didn't prove to be too big an obstacle. No, I would change nothing that I can think of, and I've just been blessed beyond any judgment that I would have on it. It's been an amazing trip for me. It really has.
Well, you're a true statesman, I'll say that. I think the world of you, too, and I know all the Easley people think a lot of you, and
well, they sure have treated me well. And one thing that I will mention that I've been able to do is help several kids to college. Some to get in, some to have loaned a little money here and there. But I wouldn't change anything. And I know that's a bold statement to make, but I really do feel that way. I will make this statement. I'm amazed at people that come into this building who don't have anybody to talk to, and they need somebody to listen. And a lot of times I've been able to be that person.